Oh god, another banner, another piece of crippling depression. For me, I already have Icy and Barbara. However, I do want Klecken, and so for that 5-star, for the guaranteed 5-star, I'm gonna go for it. A 25% chance. What could go wrong, right? Alright, let's hit it one time. Let's freaking go. I believe there's actually like a... Is it Justin Bieber song? That's like one time. One time. Anyway, a blue. Zoya, that ain't it. Oh, hold up. I'm starting to get these star jammies. All right, next, what have we got? Let's skip Reno. Next one. Okay, another blue. Such is life, you know? We can't have everything in life. Can't have a little bit of average luck. Come on, man. All right, number three, let's go. Come on, just give me that Klecken. Oh, man, Klecken would really... Okay, that's another purple. Uriah, cool. Uriah. Next. At least it's not a blue, right, guys? Four? I think that's four, right? I started on 12, so I should actually be ending up on two left. Okay, another blue. Unimit, such is life. Oh my god, the amount of copium that I have, like, actually smoked in these last... Oh my god. I don't know, guys. I've been having insanely bad luck in, like, these last 2 weeks, and it's just really getting to me. I think, like... So much copium. I just can't even breathe like normal air anymore. All right, that's Lilium. You know, at least she's kind of cute. Got five. We are five pulls in, so I've got five pulls left. Bam, purple. Okay. You know, it's average luck. This is average luck, right? Typically speaking, you do take about 10 pulls to get a 5-star. Next, we are four left. So I think this is number 7. Okay, let's go. Nope. Come on, just give me an early 5. Give me the early 5, man. I don't really want to be on this banner, man. I really don't want to be here. Okay, a blue. Okay. Ofina, welcome again for like the 50th time. All right, so this is roll 9 and 10, so we might as well go the whole hog, right? Yeah. Okay, a blue. So it should be the next one. All right, come on. Klecken, pray for me, boys. Pray for me. Moment of truth. Please, please, please. Please be Klecken. Please be Klecken. Hi, welcome back to another Alchemy Stars video. My name is Lace, and today we're going to be talking about Icy, Klecken, and Barbara, kind of like evaluating the characters on this rotating recommended recruitment. If you guys want a TLDR, if you guys don't want to watch me for more than like 3 minutes, then I'll just say, yeah, go freaking roll it. Like for starters, we've got a cat maid, we've got another cat, and then we've got a tentacle boy. I don't know like what more you could possibly want. But with all of that being said, I'm going to go through each of these characters. I actually use Icy so much, and I do believe that I have a pretty good understanding of both Klecken and Barbara. And so without further ado, let's just jump into the video and start looking at them. All right, gang, welcome to Icy. And it's pretty cool that I don't have to look up a database because I actually have one of the 6 stars I'm evaluating. And so let's have a quick look at her skills. So let me click this bad boy. Come on, open up. And so what we have here is on the active steel, converts the 4 nearest blue or green tiles to red. Remember, guys, I am evaluating her at a breakthrough 0. And so like we are getting this on a preemptive 2-round cooldown. You guys already know what it is. This skill is golden. Absolutely golden. All converters are golden, actually. But especially the converters that convert you 4 tiles of like any of the other elements other than their own on a 2-second cooldown with a preemptive. Now that's really golden. That's like golden curry golden, you know what I'm saying? And so there really isn't too much to talk about the converters. Like you guys already know, I rate converters like so highly. And so therefore you can kind of already infer what I want to talk about for Klecken, right? He's got also the 4-tile conversion. And so he's going to be like also golden shower golden. However, what's interesting is that in the forest types, there's actually a little bit of clash in terms of the conversions. And so that kind of makes it a little bit sucky compared to the rest. But yeah, I'll talk about that in another video. But again, this is probably one of the most straightforward skills that everybody knows. This is like a 10 out of 10 for me. There's not really much to be said. However, what is interesting is that Icy is actually one of the converters that does not produce enhanced tiles. So if I pop over to, who was it? I think it was Faust. where is my boss, Faust? And so as you guys can see, he has a chance to generate up to 2 enhanced tiles. And then I believe there's actually another character that does it. I don't think it's Gronru, but it should be Sariel. And so as you can see on her active skill, she also has the chance to generate up to 2 enhanced tiles. Now, this actually kind of begs the question, like, why don't Gronru and IC actually have this enhanced tile generation as well? To be honest, I don't know, but like all things considered, I do think that IC is like probably one of the stronger converters. And for me, the reason why is just that the rest of her kit is like really, really solid. Everything is really useful. Like she does quite a fair bit of damage and she kind of, not really, but kind of doubles up as like a pseudo healer. Not really, not really. She just kind of gives you like an extra bit of sustain so you can probably run healerless if you combine her with like Victoria, for example. But anyway, let's go on to her chain combo. So this is a very, very straightforward chain combo, which I would actually imagine would come with like a sniper. The range on this bad boy is actually really freaking good. But on top of that, the damage at only 3 combo, it's like 170%. And so that's really big. However, it does only hit 2 enemies, but it is homing. Like you don't have to aim this at anywhere. It's just like any enemies within like 3 surrounding clusters. And so yes, whilst this isn't a boss killing move, it is actually quite a good targeted move that could actually supplement, or not really replace, but like I do think that supplement was the right word. It's like if you're not running a sniper, which I don't in my fire team, I actually don't think I have any snipers, IC can kind of do that job for you. And so yeah, I'm a big fan of her chain combo. It doesn't scale really well. Like it goes up to 10, but realistically her 3 is already really freaking good. And so with that being said, let's move on to equipment skills, Soul Optics. So this one's a little bit dank. So every 3 rounds, Holo can be activated or saved for future use. And so when you go into battle, if you look at her portrait, so if you guys do remember, or like if you did watch my hero video, you remember that there's like a little star next to the portrait. And so IC actually has the same thing when her Holo is active. And so when she consumes her Holo, her chain combo damage ignores defense, which is actually really freaking big. But on top of that, it deals damage equal to 80% of IC's attack. And her, okay, it's okay. Her attack stat, you know, it's a converter, it's okay damage. Like typically speaking, other attack units probably have like 2.3k, 2.4k at this point. But anyway, again, she's a converter. She is getting this damage, like 80% of this, but like ignoring defense. And then on top of that, she's going to actually heal your team by the same amount of damage that she dealt. However, on top of that bad boy, this healing actually scales with like your missing HP. So yeah, all in all, it's really good. I really like the offensive supports, or like the offensive converters, because not only are they filling the conversion role, but they're also filling like some level of DPS. And so what I want to kind of compare this to is like another converter, for example, Sariel. So if we have a look at her like equipment skill, it's not really it, right? Now this defense skill, I am sure there is actually utility in it, but like generally speaking, you don't want to be hit anyway. I'm a firm believer of offense is the best defense. However, a dead offense is no offense as well. And so whilst I completely get Sariel's utility, I do prefer like the IC utility, or rather than utility, I'd say the IC damage instead. But yeah, guys, that's IC in a nutshell. And actually, ooh, I forgot to talk about this, but this has been really, really handy. And so what I'm referring to is this dual element with the blue. And like, I think it's actually come in clutch like a couple of times. It's not like the greatest thing in the world. You run fire teams to do fire damage, but like sometimes this little bit of extra flexibility has really helped. But otherwise, AC, IC, or actually, if you guys do know how to pronounce her name, somebody let me know. But yeah, in summary, one of the top tier units, like a converter, she's got offensive and support capabilities. I love her. She and a lot of the other converters are the first units to go into my teams when I form them, and she is probably the last one I would ever take out. And so with that being said, let's move on to the next unit, our boy Klecken. I don't have Klecken, but let's go to Barbara first then. All right, and somehow I did end up back on your boy's database. Like, this is life, because I did not unlock, or I did not upgrade Barbara enough to talk about her. And so let's do her evaluation here on the website. And so let's start off with her active skill, which is a massive, massive control skill. Personally, I think this skill is quite good. I don't think it's like exceptionally busted, because what you have is 550% damage to all enemies. So it's indiscriminate. It's not aimed. You can hit everybody. And on top of that, it does stun all enemies on red tiles. And if there are enemies on the other tiles, they do have a 35% chance of being stunned. However, again, I'm personally not a big fan of stun. I know there are a lot of people that are fans of stuns. And so as with like a lot of other characters that are not converters, because converters are everywhere, I do think that Barbara definitely has a place, especially like when you do need to like stun things. However, with this 5-turn CD, it's just like really, really long to be like massively impactful. It's kind of like in terms of tempo, you go at like massive tempo and then you suddenly drop back down again. If you are able to get her breakthroughs though, like having it on a 4-turn CD is better, but like I think you guys already know I'm a massive fan of the 3-turn CD skills. I just completely prefer tempos that are like kind of like that rather than tempos that are like that, right? And so that's my opinion on the active skill. Like it's pretty decent, but like that massive 5-turn cooldown is a real turnoff. With the breakthrough on a 4-turn CD, it's okay. But when I think of like good 4-turn CD skills, I think of stuff like Carlene's, which is a teleport as well as like a paint across an entire column. I would 100% take that over this. However, then you could say that like I'm not following my philosophy, where offense is the best defense and this is dealing a 550% damage to all enemies. Like technically speaking, I should be saying it's really good. But yeah, I think I've discussed the skill enough for you guys to kind of like understand where my head is at for this. And so let's go look at her equipment, where increases all deployed members' damage against enemies occupying red tiles by 5%. That's pretty decent. So this is really good because it is really reminiscent of like a support type equipment. Well, she is a support after all, but essentially it's a final damage multiplier. And like, to be honest, those are really, really good. And so this equipment actually really reminds me of like Sinza's equipment, where he inflicts defense down every time he hits somebody. I personally think like these types of passives are really, really good. However, Sinza's does not have a conditional, whereas this one does. But what this kind of has that Sinza's does not is kind of like it's got range, right? And so for Sinza's to work, you actually have to go around and hit them first before you do anything. But if you're using like some AoE skills or range skills or like point and click skills, that kind of stuff, then in that scenario, this could actually have an effect in which like Sinza's wouldn't, right? And so I think it's good, but generally speaking, I would say I prefer more passive like Sinza's instead. But there are definitely worse equipments than this. So like I would rate it. It's decent. It's a good one. All right, guys. And last of all, we've got the chain combo, 145% damage to 12 tiles in a diamond shape. Diamond shape, radial shape, two surrounding clusters. You guys already know what I want to say about this. The cost of this one actually is quite high, although the range is really good. I think the diamond shape is nice. It's not the greatest, but it's nice because it's almost two clusters. It's got like some nice range around like some of the auto placements. However, the cost of this chain combo is 4 tiles, which is actually, it's really normal, I think. I personally think this one is good. I think this one is good. However, I'm just not a fan of the radials. The radials, the crosses, like in my opinion, they are quite flexible because it means that you can position to hit really far enemies like a sniper. But yeah, generally speaking, I'm just a fan of these two, like especially when you're walking up like near a boss and then you're just gonna chunk them for that diamond shape. And then so on a 2x2 boss with the diamond shape, you'd be hitting 3 of their cells out of 4 possible. And with the two surrounding clusters, you'd be hitting 4 out of 4, right? This bad boy over here is only gonna hit like 3 tiles on a 2x2 boss. However, you can already achieve that with this boy over here, and like the damage increment is not overly much. Okay, I'm gonna stop trashing on radials. You guys already know how I feel about this. I honestly think like there are no real bad designs. I think what it really comes down to is personal preference. I just don't prefer radial, and you guys already know that. And so with all of that being said, would I roll on the banner for Barbara? I would say no. I just think that there are a lot of other high priority 5 stars. I'm talking like Faust. I'm talking like Leona. I really do think that Barbara is good. And honestly, on release week, everyone was like, man, Barbara is awesome. You either run Barbara or Isvan. I just don't think she is like necessary critical. You know what I mean? On the other hand, I do think that Klecken is like necessary critical. I do think that Icy is like necessary and critical. And so whilst she's good, I don't think you should go in looking for her. And so with that being said, let's move on to Klecken. I wish I got Klecken on that role. And so welcome to Klecken. And to be honest, Klecken has been like one of my most wanted characters ever since I started the game. And the reason honestly is just because of this. That's all I really want him for, right? All right, so let's talk about this. Converts the 4 nearest green tiles to blue and has a chance to generate up to 2 enhanced tiles. This is only good. This is only good. I don't know what else I can say about this, okay? Cookie cutter, 2-turn preemptive, 4-tile conversion on a 5-star unit. This is as good as it gets, my dudes. Moving on, let's talk about the equipment. After using a chain combo, inflicts fright on one enemy with the lowest HP within 4 tiles of it in a cross shape for 1 round. Oh my god, that was such a mouthful, but let's keep going. Killing a frightened enemy has a 50% chance to inflict fright on enemies within 4 tiles of it in a cross shape. All it's really saying is that after you use a chain combo, you're gonna inflict fright on one enemy with the lowest HP, so that's predictable, which is good. It's not random. And this is only going to occur for mobs with less than 80% HP, and if they are within 4 tiles of it in a cross shape for 1 round. And then on top of that, it's kind of like a second part to the passive, which isn't related to the first. So if you do kill a frightened enemy, it has a 50% chance to inflict fright onto another enemy, essentially. And so I do know that a lot of people actually do not like fright. And I completely understand why, right? Because fright essentially gets like your enemies moving randomly. I actually don't know if it's random. You know what? Let me ask you guys, if you guys know like if fright is random or not, if it does actually have like some sort of pathing or some sort of pattern, let me know down in the comments. But from what I know, it's random. And so like it removes a lot of predictability in terms of like where they're actually going to go. And so the alternative to fright is like enemies moving towards you, right? And generally speaking, you can predict where they will move based on where you are on the map. On top of that, fright actually moves enemies away from you. So that means it's actually going to take you more turns potentially for you to be able to like kill them off. And so it's for these kinds of reasons that I completely understand why people do not like fright. As for me personally, I'm kind of indifferent to fright. Like I think it's good. It doesn't really bother me too much. However, I have 100% encountered these kinds of frustrations, like enemies just running to the other side of the field. Like it really sometimes does get annoying. But yeah, this is essentially like a pure CC equipment. It's not giving you too much damage. If anything, it boosts your survivability. That's really it for fright, right? And so again, as always, it is situational. If you guys do want to survive, fright is a good thing. But like if you do want to like clear a stage ASAP, it may not be. And so I think we've talked about that one enough. And so let's start talking about the chain combo. So we've got a cross, a radial shape, and a radial shape to the maximum range. So across, we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yep. And then we've got the radials, which is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. So again, just not a massive fan of the crosses nor the radials. Like you guys already know, it's the range. It doesn't really do too much to bosses. I'm of the opinion that you're just going to like walk around the smaller mobs and just wreck them, right? But yeah, that's kind of it for this one. Like the damage numbers look, whoa, hold up. Actually, wait a second. That's only a 2 cost to deal this one over here. That is quite good because there are actually quite a few scenarios where I'm being a little cheeky and I only move like 2 cells. And so on that note, this first chain combo on the 2 cell requirement, I think it does give you a little bit of flexibility to dish out that extra little bit of damage if you're like being a little cheeky, you know? However, I do think that there are better. So for example, I believe Karan's is also on a 2 cost for the chain combo for the first stage. So let me just click into him. And so as you can see, 2 cost for the chain combo, 170% for one surrounding cluster. Oh, baby. But I can't really compare like a converter to a detonator. It's not really fair. And so just going back to Klecken, I think it is a pretty solid skill, especially with that like 2 cost for the first starting one. But yeah, like looking through all of this, no boss killing capabilities, but like, you know what? I forgive you, Klecken, because you are one of these guys. You are one of the holy blessed ones. I just really wish that you came home and blessed me. You know what I'm saying? But I guess with that being said, there's not too much left to be said. And so let's start wrapping up this video. And so I've got a secret question for you guys. Are you guys going to be rolling on this banner, Icy, Klecken, Barbara? I personally do think that especially if you don't have Klecken and Icy or like one or the other, I think it's worth at least putting in those like guaranteed rolls for the 5-star. But yeah, let me know down in the comments below. Did you guys roll? Did you not roll? If you did roll, what did you get? Because if you do leave a comment, it means you've actually watched the video up until the end. And so thank you guys so much. Otherwise, please consider a like, a sub, a comment, a follow. You guys already know what it is. If you do want to support the channel, we've got a membership button as well as affiliate links in the description below. Come join the Discord if you want to chill. But otherwise, as Klecken once said, all good things must come to an end. And so thank you guys so much for watching, and I will catch you guys in the next video. Bye-bye.